Hi guys, it's me, Teacher Gon. In our today's video, we will talk about this problem set. Actually, this problem set is under transversal line. And kung gusto mong pag-aralan yung ating video about it, puntahan mo sa ating description box. Nandun yung ating unang video about transversal. Now, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to like and subscribe at i-hit na rin yung bell button for you to be updated sa ating latest uploads. Again, I'm Teacher Gon. Let's do this topic. So basically guys, this one is transversal. So yun, ang given natin dito, we have angle 4, which is equivalent to 2x minus 7 degrees, and angle 5 is equivalent to 3x plus 13 degrees. And in this figure, side O is parallel to side N. Itong side O natin, line O is parallel to line N. And G, or line G, is the transversal. So, if ito yung case natin, we can apply the different properties if two parallel lines are cut by transversal. So, ito yung problem set natin. Answer the following. Find x, and we're asked to find the measurement of all the angles, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, 5, up to 8. And to solve this problem, isipin muna natin, di ba, two parallel lines are cut by transversal, meaning yung mga properties natin about different angle pairs natin doon ay applicable dito. So, analyzing this given figure, we have angle 4 and angle 5. Anong angle pair ba ang angle 4 and angle 5? So basically, they are same side interior angles. And ano ba yung property natin about that? Ang sabi doon, if two parallel lines are cut by transversal, therefore, same side interior angles are supplementary. If they're supplementary, we can create an equation like this. We have 2x minus 7 plus 3x plus 12 is equal to 180 degrees. So, since they are supplementary, pwede natin i-add yung measurement ng dalawang angle and it will sum up into 180. Okay? 180. So, adding this or simplifying this equation, it will give you 2x plus 3 minus 7 plus 12 is equal to 180 degrees. And simplifying this kind of equation, this is 5x plus 5 is equal to 180 degrees. And para mas madali yung ating solution, we can transpose 5 or positive 5 to the other side of the equation, wherein 2 become 5x is equal to 180 minus 5. And you have 5x is equal to 175. And to find the value of x, divide both sides by 5. And 175 divided by 5, your x is equal to 35. Ito yung value ng x natin. Okay? So we can, pwede nyo kopyahin yung ating solution. This is the answer here. So, x is equal to 35. Okay? So, burin mo na ito. Tuloy-tuloy lang natin. Ngayon, since you already have the value of x, which is 35, and kung mapansin nyo naman, para ma-solve natin itong measurements ng angle 1 up to angle 8, we need to find first the value of angle 4 and angle 5. Okay? So, for angle 4, yung ating value is represented by 2x minus 7 degrees. And to find the measurement of this angle, we need to substitute x is equal to 35 here. So it will become 2 times 35, okay, minus 7 degrees. So basically, this is 70 minus 7 degrees. Your angle 4 is simply equal to 63 degrees. Okay? Ito yung ating angle 4. 63 degrees. So we can write here 63 degrees. Ngayon, kailangan ba natin i-substitute yung value ng x sa ating angle 5? Hindi na. Kasi alam naman natin, di ba sabi kanina, since they are same side interior angles, therefore, they are supplementary. So we can subtract your angle 5, to find the angle 5, we can subtract 63 degrees from 180. So you have 63 degrees, wherein your angle 5 is equivalent to 117, right? 17 degrees. Ito ngayon yung measure ng ating angle 5. Okay, tama ba tayo? Okay, tama. Angle 5 is equal to 117 degrees. 117 degrees. So, bubuling ko ito ngayon. Pwede natin ilagay dito sa measurement natin. Angle 4 is 63 degrees. And this is 117 degrees. The question here, sir, how about angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 6, 7, and 8? So, apply natin different properties. Ngayon, if this is, sorry, if this is 63, and this is 117 degrees, this 63, madali natin makukuha yung angle 1 because angle 4 and angle 1 are supplementary. And another thing na pwede nyo gamitin is that angle 5 is corresponding to angle 1, meaning they are congruent. This is also 117 degrees. This is 117 degrees. Again, ang reason bakit 117 is that angle 5 and angle 1 are congruent because they are corresponding angles. At the same time, angle 4 and angle 1 are supplementary angles. So let's move on with angle 2. Yung angle 2 natin, ang easiest way ay gamitin natin yung 4 and 2 as vertical angles. Remember, vertical angles are congruent. So this is also 63 degrees. And for angle 3, angle 3 is vertical to 1. Ito ngayon ay equal, so 117 degrees. So 117 degrees. So for angle 6, ano bang pwede natin gamitin? Angle 2 and angle 6 are corresponding angles, therefore they are congruent. So 63 degrees din ito. And aside from that, 5 and 6 are supplementary. Okay? Supplementary sila. So this is 63 degrees. For angle 7, 5 and 7 are vertical. So this is 117 degrees. Ang dami pwedeng reason eh. Another reason is that 6 and 7 are supplementary angles. Another possible reason is that angle 3 and angle 7 are corresponding angles. Okay? And last reason is that, and another reason is that we have angle 1 and angle 7 are alternate exterior angles. Therefore, they are congruent. So this is 117 degrees. And lastly, for angle 8, alam naman natin pattern, this is 63 degrees. And basic reason is that angle 6 and angle 8 are congruent because they are vertical angles. Okay? So if you have any question or suggestion kung gusto nyo yung topic na i-discuss natin within our channel, you can comment down below. And again, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to like and subscribe at i-hit mo na rin yung bell button for you to be updated sa ating latest uploads. Again, I am Teacher Gon. Maraming salamat. Bye-bye!